They'll run on first down. Timmons. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
It's now second and six.
They'll keep it on the ground. Timmons. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go.
3 yard pickup. And it's third down.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. Now he's got it. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. From 8 yards out. And the Saints now at 6 to their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. McCrane on for the extra point.
For the point after.
And that stretches the lead to 27. Just a 4-play drive that time. And it ends with a touchdown for New Orleans.
Matthew McCrane.
Following the touchdown, McCrane set to kick it away. And this will make it into the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. And Denver getting set to take the field. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there halftime, actually.
You think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Let's face it, when you have a guy who can pick up those types of runs and keep the chains moving or stay ahead of the chains, you're making everyone else on offense happy because you're opening things up to allow for a whole lot of different play calls.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. On play action, lock. Oh, he'll air this one deep for... This is caught at the 20. And he'll be down deep into New Orleans territory. A huge play there for Denver. 46 yards.
At this stage, there's nothing left to do but to keep firing. And if you're a play caller, you may go off your sheet and use some things maybe you hadn't planned to in this game. Maybe that was one of them there that worked.
So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. Right there. Into the red zone, it's Locke. They'll get that one to Taylor complete.
Locke pass.
That catch good for only a couple. So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down.
A gain of 2.
From the gun, Locke. He'll find Taylor. That's complete. And the Broncos are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2 yard line. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. Again, it's Locke. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9 yard line.
Well, if you're going to throw the ball on first and goal from the 2, the worst thing that should result is an incompletion for you offensively. But, Brandon, this is a different type of football. Back in my day, first and goal from the 2, a lot of big people with big neck rolls, they were on the field trying to ram it into the end zone.
Now from the 9, here's second and goal. Operating from the gun, Locke. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. Yeah, this is caught by Sutton. Touchdown, Broncos. Cortland Sutton, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Broncos get a bit closer.
Well, if you've got him in your fantasy league, you like his production, his second touchdown of the game. But right now, his team is trailing. Fortunately, he's playing pretty well, trying to keep him in it.
Yeah, they might need a little more from him here.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they continue to call his number. Right now, he needs his defense to step up and give him a chance.
And the lead is down to 20.
It is good.
So that drive in total, 8 plays. And it ends with a Denver touchdown.
28.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
26-yard line.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. They're looking at a third straight win here if they can hold on. On first down. Timmons, and from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. Second and six, just inside the 30.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and six.
They'll keep it on the ground. Timmons, and he stopped immediately there. The Saints on third down. They've been tough to stop. 8 for 10 so far. This is third and seven. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their edge, their gaps, and have the offense hit them with a big play.
Here comes the Saints punter now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. Set to take over, the Broncos offense trots back out. Even though they were able to force the punt defensively, still a big hole to climb out of, especially at this late stage of the contest. Lock now on first down. Got a man open, it's Sutton. And he'll be corralled right around the 34.
That's good.
Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
First and 10 at the 34-yard line.
On first down, Locke. And Locke throws another one. It's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line.
By the Saints.
Both defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get them this lead, and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
It's been a game of punch counterpunch, hasn't it? All throughout. But this time, the big swing was taken, and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
They'll run on first down. Timmons, and he'll be brought down at about the 25 after a pickup of four.
Number 20.
Well, that's a pretty good drive starter right there, and I don't know, partner, if you're even thinking about sitting on the ball right now. They may just want to run their regular offense.
In plus territory, and as an offensive coordinator, you don't want your team to go into a shell, do you?
No, you really don't, because as soon as you take your foot off the gas, it's real hard to put it back on and mash it, because once everyone's emotions come down, hard to start them up again. So I think you may want to keep them cranking high right here.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7.
The ball carried by number
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
7 yard line. It's a pickup of 3.
Again, here's Adams. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great play there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Saints take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash in for 6. And that moment we just saw, always so special for any rookie, the first touchdown of his career.
And there's nothing like anticipation, is there? You know he's been dreaming about it, thinking about it. It's been a part of every bit of his being. And finally, it gets done. He's got to feel great right now.
Extra point by McCrain, up and good. And that stretches the lead all the way up to 27.
Matthew McCrain.
Following the touchdown, McCrain set to kick it away. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
We see Drew Lock in the offense coming back on. And that interception that ended their previous drive likely also ended any shot they had at victory.
Yeah, long road back from here, no doubt about that one. But let's face it, if you're going to go out there and compete, you want to try and end on a strong note, don't you?
Absolutely. It won't end in a victory, like you said, but they can maybe take something positive out of this one. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up 2nd and 2 at the 33-yard line.
Shotgun snap to Lock. Quick hitter here, it's complete. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Now a play fake, and here's Lock. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off at the 38. And he'll get it all the way down inside the 35-yard line.
Intercepted by the Saints.
This spot in the 4th quarter with that deficit, had to throw the football. Unfortunately, there's the risk of big turnover.
And you know you're going to be throwing against nickel, dime, all sorts of exotic defenses, but you have to do it anyway. Ordinarily, you might want to run the football a little bit, try and get them out of it. But as you noted, this time of the game, this point on the clock, had to throw it.
On 1st down, this is Adams. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
Number 39. The tackle by Zach Allen. 2 yards on the pickup. It's 2nd.
They'll run again with Adams.
32-yard line.
And he'll be down close to the 1st down marker as he gets this to the Broncos 23. Give him 8 yards there. Still a few inches to go, though, as it'll be 3rd down at about the length of the football.
3rd and inches.
The Saints on 3rd down. They've had plenty of success. 8 conversions, looking for a 9th. They're looking at 3rd and a few inches. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. They're able to convert with a gain of 4.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on 3rd down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, 3rd down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. On 1st down, Adams. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5.
Brings up 2nd and 5 at the 15-yard line.
His pass caught at the 4. And the Saints are looking at 1st and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line. And they've got 3 tight ends here on 1st and goal to add some extra mass. They'll go to Adams, try to pound it in. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line. line of scrimmage.
I just wonder if before that last play, if someone on the defense stepped in the huddle and said, we've been run over, run around, run through all game long. Can we come up with one stop right here? And on that play, they did.
So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans.
New Orleans.
From 3 yards out, and the Saints just continue to roll.
Well, where our booth is here, we can see all of the writers to our left, and their post-game stories, Charles, they have been filed for some time because this game, boy, is it lopsided.
Yeah, we can see our guy Scoop. He's even got his fedora tipped over his face. I think he's taking a nap now. Nothing left to write for him, but how gratifying has it been for them to see what they've done in practice and carry it into a game and see the execution be so good? They've got to feel fantastic about what they've accomplished in this one.
And his kick is good. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it all culminates in a Saints touchdown.
Matthew McCrane.
Following the touchdown, McCrane set to kick it away. Taken in at the 3. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24.
Take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Bronco offense now set to come back out onto the field. Now, they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. Now left side on the swing pass. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 7 yards there on the first down screenplay. Under 4 to go now as they come up on second down.
Brings up second.
And he's going to have the hook up to Sutton. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Again, they'll throw with Locke. Short little throw to Ebron. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
A 7-yard pickup brings up second and 3 at the Saints.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. Now Locke again. Over the middle into traffic, and that's complete.
That's another.
And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. 9 yards the pickup there, and it's a first down. Locke looks to throw it again. And now here is another interception. Picked off at about the 31. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. CD, this defense, man, at this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on, no one wants to come out of the game. They all want their shot at picking off a pass.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll begin here with Adams. A gain of 3, second down.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run-pass option. And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. He'll wind up getting 3 on the keeper there, but it leads to a third down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk-reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
And Thomas seems to be in some pain. He's still on the ground.
We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. They'll keep it on the ground. Adams. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
2-yard gain on the play. And it's 3rd down.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line.
Intercepted.
Now they get a 4th quarter pick, a little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other, but it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over.
Right there.
After the turnover, here's Locke to the right side to Eric Ebron. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
That's good.
So he hooked up with a veteran there, and in overtime, that's not a bad idea. Go with the age and the experience.
Yeah, because sometimes the young guys, they give you the fresh legs and give you all that bounce. But in this type of a situation, sometimes those legs slow down a little bit as the enormity of the moment overwhelms them. The veteran guys, they tend to come through.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon, everyone, as we say so long from Denver.
Tie me up in chains, I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go, but I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smell, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables, yeah. Look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come on, call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes while you walk your pugs in a town you create where there ain't no love.
What?